everyone, Sean Clement here, Wisdom in Golf, for our weekly question and answer. And Lewis has got a question for us here. He says, could you please elaborate on the eventual differences one can find when hitting a wood or a hybrid in comparison to an iron? I'll tell you why. I hit all my irons pretty straight, but slice all my woods and hybrids. Why is that so? Okay, great question. Now, you'll notice I have one of my old irons here, and I've got one of my older woods, and the center of mass of the wood is much farther back, so it's a very different configuration. Now also, you'll notice the iron is a nice straight face, whereas the wood, the way it was created, has a little bit more of a bulge and roll on the face. So it's a, not only is it a different configuration, but the center of gravity is completely different as well. So for certain students of mine, depending on the company that they're using, sometimes they have to close the face a lot more with the woods, which is what I would recommend you do here. And sometimes they have to open the face more. Some of the hybrids and fairway woods are draw biased. And some of my students who close the face, let's say they're closing the face nicely to hit a nice draw, and then when they get to the woods, they feel they need to open the face to get the same draw. It can be really off-putting that way. You know, you try to find a set of clubs, a set of woods that you hit as consistently as your irons. But remember, if I take my club here and I close the face significantly, at the moment of impact, my hands are going to be a lot more forward than they are at address. So you feel that the sole of the club is not going to hit the ground very well right here, but when you move the hands forward, well, now the sole of the club has just flattened itself to the ground, and the club face has squared itself to the target quite nicely. And you'll see that in my, the video we just did on lag, okay, easy lag, and prior to that, weak grip versus strong grip. And so when you're swinging to a target, and you're releasing well, so that's the first thing I would do is close the face. The second thing is watch your grip, okay? So for those of you who tend to slice out there, I see a lot of disintegrating grips where as you're swinging, the club is coming out of your hands. You actually, the fingers are losing their grip on the club and the club is prying away from the hands. So be, you know, aware that your hands stay on the club. It's an arm-club relationship. So that means from the shoulder sockets down to the club head, it's one piece, and you want to feel that it's a one piece, very secure, okay? So if the hands stay on the club, you'll find that that's what's going to force the hands to turn over properly. Another video I'd recommend that you look at is called How Arms and Club Release, Sean Clement. It gives you a really good insight on how we get leverage from the hands so that, you know, the weight of the club can fully release you. Another one is the Fencing Sword for Power video, Sean Clement, where you feel the weight of the sword release you in the swing. The tendency when you get to the longer clubs, the hybrids and woods, you're much more preoccupied with how the club is going to meet the ball, and you forget about letting the club swing you. The longer the club, the more you need to abandon control, and the more you need to let gravity do that work for you. And the tendency is, well, as the clubs get longer and the lofts get lower, the tendency is to try and control and make sure. And that's the last thing you need. So I hope that was helpful. And if anything else, I hope you've got my video series and you're a member on our premium channel, because that's really going to help you out big time. Till next week, this is Sean Clement.